Everyone, welcome back to online classes. In the last session, we have discussed many important concepts about the electricity. Now, we have to study some more important concepts about the electricity in the 10th standard 12th lesson electricity. Okay, in the first session, already we have studied 5 points we have to revise that. Electric current, charge and insulators and the conductor, and also the circuit diagram. What is circuit diagram? It is a closed and continuous path of an electric current. And the circuit diagram contains many important components like battery, bulb, emitter and plug key and also connecting wire. So it is a circuit diagram already we have studied in the last session. So now current, it is a rate of flow of charge through the conductor, and conductor means the materials which allows the electricity pass through them, they are conductors. And insulators means the materials which do not allow the electricity to pass through them, they are called as insulators. Insulators also called as poor conductors or bad conductors of electricity. Then charge means it's the property of the atom. Now let us continue the concept. Today I'm going to discuss with you all some more important concepts about electric potential and potential difference, then Ohm's law and some components used in the electric circuit. So first I will start the electric potential or potential difference. What is that? Electric potential and potential difference. Let's start. Before going to this concept, I want to clarify some basic information, that is conductor. You know that the conductor have a two edges, you know, that is a positive pole and the negative pole, right? The electrons are easily flowing through the conductor from positive pole to the negative pole, right? Dear students, in the circuit diagram here, I want to show you one thing here. So this is the battery. So this is the one end of the conductor and this is a one more end of the conductor. The conductors are connected. The two ends of the conductor are connected to a battery. Here, I am going to clarify one thing for you all. When you supply the electricity, the electric current is always flow from positive pole to the negative pole. Dear students, here always electrons are flowing through the reverse order. It means the current is always flowing in the direction opposed to the flow of electrons. This is very important concept, my dear students. I think you are followed, I think. So next, now let us discuss the potential difference or electrical potential. I think electrons, the electrons are not flow easily through the conductor themselves. Is it so? So why or how? Why the electrons are not flowing through the conductor easily? So this we come to know by connecting one simple activity. So dear students, here I taken two glass jars and filled same amount of water in the both the beakers, and both the beakers are connected one pipe at a pipe. So dear students, here I'll clarify one thing. Here the both the beakers have a same amount of water, right? So here, do you know or can you tell me the water flow from one beaker to another beaker? Is it flow the water from one beaker to another beaker? So this is first beaker and this is second beaker. So just you keenly observe the two beakers, both beakers have a equal amount of water and both ends of the pipe have a same pressure. So that's why the water do not flow from one beaker to the another beaker. So dear students, can you say, is it possible the water flow from second beaker to first beaker? Is there any ideas? So there is a simple idea is there. What does that mean, sir? Just I raise the second beaker little upwards. So here, height. What happens? The water easily flow from one beaker to another beaker, right? Why the water is easily flow from one beaker to another beaker through the pipe? Because here the pressure is increased. The pressure is increased at the one end of the pipe, and pressure is here decreased or lesser than this. So the water can flow easily from one beaker to another beaker by a factor called height. So in the same manner, I want to say now, the electrons are not flow easily through the conductor by themselves. Then how the electrons are flowing through the conductor easily? So in the similar manner, what I shown for you two people here, I will clarify one thing here. In the circuit diagram, battery or many cells. When we connected the battery or many cells, those create one pressure that is called as electric pressure on the both ends of the cell or both ends of the battery. Means when we connected battery or cell, they are produce the electric pressure in the both ends of the conductor. Then the difference in the electric pressure is called as a potential difference or the electric potential. Are you followed, my dear students? Then what is potential difference? The potential difference is mainly produced by the battery or the many cells. They are produced the, or the battery or many cells are produced the potential difference and across the ends of the cell or the battery. So here, what is the potential difference? The work done in bringing or moving a unit positive charge from infinite distance to the that point is called as potential difference. Once I clarify, my students, the amount of work done, or the amount of work done in bringing or moving a unit charge, a unit positive charge from one position to the another position. So the first position I have to say infinite position or infinite distance and another point is called as the potential difference or electric potential. Here the potential difference can be represented by the letter V, and the SI unit is volt. The SI unit of the potential difference or electric potential is that is volt. Some more information is here. Mathematically, the potential difference can be expressed. Electric potential equals to work done divided by the flow of charge. So V equals to W by Q. Here V stands for electric potential, W stands for work, and Q stands for charge. Here some more points I want to say now. Here in the conductor, I said two poles are there, that is positive pole and the negative pole, means positive charge and the negative charge. The positive charge is taken as a positive potential and a negative charge is taken as a negative potential. Once I repeat, my dear students, so positive charge is taken as potential or positive potential, and negative charge is taken as a negative potential. One more important here, always the positive potential is higher than the negative potential. Always the positive potential is higher than the negative potential. So here in the case of circuit diagram, if the potential difference across its terminals of the cell or battery is increased, simultaneously, suddenly the current also increased in the circuit. When the ends of the cell or a battery, the potential is goes on increasing, suddenly the current also increased. Right? So this is about some concept about electric potential or potential difference. So next, I want to discuss with you the important components are used in a electric circuit. Here I taken the components in circuit diagrams. In every circuit diagrams, we have to use some components. So here I made the two columns. One is components of a circuit and their symbol, right? So first one is an electric cell. This is the symbol of the electric cell. Here the longer line indicates the positive sign and the shorter line indicates the negative charge. And second one, a battery or combination of cells. Battery means two or more cells are combined to form a battery. Longer line positive and shorter line negative. And third one is plug key or switch open, plug key or switch closed. Here open means the electric current is not flowing through the circuit, right? And plug key or switch is closed means there is a electric current easily flowing through the circuit. Dear students, next one is a wire joint. Here in houses, school, colleges, many buildings, means new construct buildings, we have to electric supply, you know, there is a wire joint. So different wires we have to join and get the electric connection. Next, wire crossing without joining means, so many crossing, the wire should crossing in the fixing of electric current in the houses, so without joining. Then electric bulb, this is the symbol of electric bulb, you may use any one. Electric bulb is it's an component of it produces the light and also heat. Then a resistance of resistor, symbol of the resistance of the resistor. Here resistor is a device or a component which has considerable resistance, that is called as a resistance of the resistor. Next one is variable resistance or rheostat. What is the rheostat here? It is a component or a small device which is used to increase or decrease the resistance. The next one is emitter. Already I said in the first session, emitter, it is an device which is used to measure the electric current in the circuit. And last one is voltmeter. Means voltmeter, it is a device which is used to find the potential difference in the circuit. So this is the symbol. Here is a positive sign, here is a negative sign. Dear students, here I want to show you all current in a purely resistive electric circuit. It is a electric circuit, not a simple electric circuit. It's a purely resistive. Here I connected resistor, right? Voltmeter, ammeter, battery, closed plug key, and these are the connecting wires. See here, one thing I want to clarify for you all. Here, as you know already, in a electric circuit or circuit diagram, emitter is always connected in series because of it has a low resistance. Similarly, voltmeter has a high resistance. It is always connected in the parallel. Then here R stands for resistor. Resistor is a small component which has the considerable resistance. Is it clear students? And here arrow mark I shown here. This is the flow of current from positive pole to the negative pole. Here this is a closed plug key. Closed means already there is a connection will be there. Current is easily flowing from positive pole to the negative pole. So this is some concept about some components are used in circuit diagrams with their symbol. right, my children, students? Next, I am going to discuss with you one more important concept, that is the Ohm's law. Here, I made very simple for you all about the Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? So, in the year of 1827, John Simon Ohm, he was a German physicist. He found that relationship between the current and the potential difference across the terminals of the circuit or the conductor. Actually, in the conductor, in a conductor, if all the physical quantities, here the physical quantities means what? The temperature, pressure, shape and size. So in a conductor, if all the physical quantities are remains constant and the current or the electric current is flowing means the electric current is directly proportional to the potential difference across its ends of the conductor, is called the Ohm's law. Once I'll repeat, my dear students, listen carefully. In a conductor, if all the physical quantities are remains constant, the electric current is flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to potential difference across its ends of the conductor. So here, potential difference is directly proportional to I. Then V equals to I. Here V equals to IR. This can be right also, V equals to RI. Here R is a constant proportionality for a given metallic wire of a at given temperature and is called as the resistance. Once I repeat, my dear students, here V equals to RI, where R stands for the proportionality constant for a given metallic wire in the given temperature and is called as a resistance of the conductor. Here an important note will be there. If the resistance or if the potential difference is increased, current also increases. If the potential difference is increased, certainly the current also increases. This is the concept about the Ohm's law. And finally, I want to discuss with you the last concept of this session, that is resistance, right? Here, what is the resistance? In one word, resist means to prevent or to stop. Prevent or to stop. What is resistance is here? Resistance is the property of the conductor which resists the flow of electrons in the conductor. Or in the simple way, this is the prevention of flow of current in the conductor, is called as resistance. It is denoted by R. The SI unit is ohm. It is represented by a Greek symbol, that is a ohm. Then the value of 1 ohm equals to 1 volt by 1 ampere. Here 1 ohm means 1 volt by 1 ampere. It means the 1 ampere of current is allowed through a conductor when potential difference of 1 volt is applied through the conductor across its ends. So my dear students, today we discussed about the circuit diagrams or the components in circuit diagrams, Ohm's law, potential difference and electrical difference. So in the next session we have to discuss some more concept. Thank you. So 10 minutes.